But how is it to be back on stage?
Wonderful. Yeah. Wonderful. Feels great. It's been great. Everybody's obviously, you know, the response to the play has been enormous and amazing and very heartfelt. And I think
from the reviews to the audience to people in the street?
I speak mostly about what goes on between us and the audiences. The reviews have been great. The accolades we've received have been great. But what goes on, I mean, John can talk about it as well. When we're on stage, it's a real conversation with that audience every night, yeah. And it is a very heavy one that you are physically incapable of avoiding as an actor. It's very...
The conversation with the
audience.
The emotional conversation. The emotional... is so audible. I've done several plays, my fifth Broadway show. I have never heard an audience laugh as loud, cry as hard, as audibly. I mean, the visceral, electric, emotional reaction that is elicited from the audience is... Yeah, you can't ignore.
It's astonishing. And it's also the thing which is so, when people talk to me about the play, they don't say good work or brilliant work. They start telling stories about loss. They start sharing what happened. A friend of mine said he walked out of the theater and he saw his 20-year-old student, and a student came over to him and just broke down sobbing, and he just stood there right on 45th Street hugging him. It's very interesting because it seems to be attracting the people who lived through the time period, and because there was so much death after a while, you become numb, and so I think people are really grieving fully for the first time. And it's also attracting a very young audience who are learning of a history that they didn't know existed, and it's evoking outrage and sadness and a sense of empowerment, which I think is really, really thrilling.
Very
it's
important.
Very, very.
And also when we finish the play every night, I mean, I know what happens to us as actors is sometimes you think, okay, you'll get through the play and you'll be okay, and sometime around the second act, you are swept up by this tsunami. It's very, very hard to keep it together and not just become part of the audience, which I think has to do with the brilliant way George has staged
the play. So it's hard not to play in concert with them where you might go otherwise.
Well, George has staged it in a very brilliant way where the actors who are not in specific scenes, you know, act almost like a Greek chorus. We're observers of what's going on. And he said, and I, at one point in rehearsal, said, you know, I find myself getting very upset. What do I do? He said, do whatever you do, just do it in character. Mm. And so you start to feel from the audience this, like, it's really waves of emotion and, like, audible sighs and sobs. And it's very intense. Mm. And then after we take our curtains, we realize that nobody moves in the theater.
They just stand there.
Dead silence.
Dead silence.
Yeah, it's just really thinking extraordinary. Or just moving.
Yeah, and there's a chyron at the end that says 35 million people have died from this disease. This is where the disease stands now. This is, and I just think there's this, well, there is this deafening silence when we come off our curtain call thinking, where did they turn the monitors off? And it's just everybody filing out.
And it's also interesting that toward the end of the play, all these names are projected all over the walls of the theater. And what's interesting is I've had a number of people come up and say, I saw the name of my friend. I saw the name of my love. And there are hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of names. And people are identifying, seeing the name of a lost person, a very close person. So there's some kind of incredibly intense symbiotic dynamic that is happening between play and audience that is very rare and very unique and really quite thrilling.
Join us online at charlierose.com.